Aloha everyone, this is Beth of Cooking and Crafting, and for the last couple of weeks I have been playing around with my new GoSun solar stove. And those of you that follow me on Facebook, I said that I would be showing you some of the things that I was up to, and this is finally the time. So first of all, the solar stove is super easy to set up as well as to use. This is the Sport edition, so it's a little smaller than a standard size stove. However, big things come in small packages, because it doesn't matter that it's small, it can make a lot of food in this little tube. So anyway, one of the things is you just set it up by taking the handles that you carry it with, and you open them up and they become the legs of the stove, and they have little clips on the side. You need to set it up so that the panels will capture the best sun. So it's movable, and you know, to move it up and down, and then you get the little tray that goes in, and you set it up with what you are going to be cooking. Now what I did was I lined this with tin foil to help with the cleanup, but as you'll see, it'll fly away in just a second. And I found that even though I did that, I didn't really need it, because it is very easy to actually clean up, because some of the things, you know, like go underneath and bake on, and it doesn't take any more extra time to scrub it clean than any other thing that you would really do, you know, clean up. So it does have very easy cleanup, and really you aren't limited to anything that you can cook in this. As you'll see, I am going to be throwing together some shrimp scampi that I added some linguine to. I'm going to be making a pizza that I just use things like, if I wanted to run an escape to a beach or go to a little park and we're going to have a little cookout, I just have to take the ready-made items and throw it together, and we have a pizza at the end of that. And I also throw together a very simple dessert that, despite its simplicity, was actually very good. The tube itself is made of borosilicate glass, which is nice and thick and sturdy, semi-like Pyrex. You can cook a meal in full sunlight in mere 20 minutes. What I'm doing here with this scampi is I'm preparing it, you know, just shrimp and butter and garlic. And I went, and as soon as it goes into the oven, then I go into the house and I start preparing my linguine. When the linguine was done, so was the shrimp. So we had a meal in just a short period of time that it took me to boil the linguine. The oven can get up to 550 degrees Fahrenheit, and it works in partially cloudy weather, as you'll see later when I start to prepare the dessert, and when it's light overcast situations. So you know, it works in a variety of situations. It'll also stay hot for hours, as it's essentially a thermos, and it's always cool to the touch. The, you know, the outside and the flares, I might have a part on the here that shows Bane actually touching the panels, and at first I had kind of told him, like, you know, oh, don't do that, but what I was worried about was, you know, just the heat from the sun affecting him. But, you know, nothing, I didn't have to use a hot pad, though you have to if you plan on, you know, like touching the actual inside part that, you know, that I'm pulling out right now. So here I am, I'm just kind of testing to see how things are going while my linguine is cooking on the inside, and things are coming along quite well. One of the things that you really do want to make sure that you heed is beware of thermal shock. So you never really want to put cold food or water into a hot tube. So, like, you don't want to set your stove up ahead of time and allow it to preheat
and then introduce cold food or liquids inside of there, because just like a Pyrex pot, it will break. And the thing is that it will implode, it won't explode. So even if it does break, you know, you don't have to worry about the glass flying all over the place. But then you've gone ahead and ruined a beautiful stove. I truly, truly enjoyed playing with this thing, and I made so many different things. And my camera went crazy. And I just wanted to make sure that I showed you you how beautiful it is. And going solar by, you know, not having to turn on any heat to cook this meal. I could have done the spaghetti inside of that tube as well, but I just wanted to, you know, throw something together really quickly for lunch for all of us. So I've done a whole lot of talking, and before we go on and see a few other things, I did want to direct you into the description box, where I will have a link where you can go and get one yourself if that's what you want. And by using my promo code CookingAndCrafting at checkout, you'll get $30 off any one of their stoves there. The beautiful thing is that a portion of each purchase goes towards helping a family in need. So one in every six GoSun stoves are made available to a family in need. So here is our end product with our shrimp cooked perfectly, and we really enjoyed this for lunch. So the next day I decided to create a pizza. Scott loves pizza, and I know I've said this many times before, but I threw together this just using a ready-made pizza crust, some ready-made pizza sauce, and I just threw in some mozzarella cheese and some pizza seasoning, as well as pepperoni, and I threw this in. And about halfway through the cooking it, the sun disappeared and we started to get a little bit of inclement weather. But did it stop cooking? No, it certainly didn't. It did take a little longer than our 20-minute shrimp scampi. I think it took a total of about 1 hour. But as you'll see from the pictures, the crust became nice and beautifully crisp. The pizza tasted wonderful. Scott said he felt like it almost tasted more healthy, which is pretty funny, because actually that is one of the things that pointed out as one of the neat things about this stove. Basically, no grease was used in it, so it was very nice. As you'll notice here, I have left a little bit of an opening there. I didn't seal it completely shut. That way I allowed the steam to get out and allowed the crust of the pizza to get crispy. And then, like I said, the inclement weather sort of moved in, but regardless of the fact, it continued to cook. I finished up with the pizza, and then I made a crumble where I put some peaches in there, as well as made a nice beautiful crumble on there. And what happened was the sun came out and I left it in a little long. It didn't burn, but it also dried up most of the fruit juice. But overall, this was an absolute success. I love playing with this. I truly hope you consider getting one or gifting one to someone and enjoy. Don't forget to see the links below for your way to purchase it, as well as the promo code. And if you have any questions, please make sure you ask me them. And if I can answer them, I will definitely do so. Thanks for watching.